Feature 1. If you want to split a stereo track into two mono tracks, select the track, go to Project, Convert Tracks, and choose Multi-Channel to Mono. Then you get a whole bunch of options. Do you want to keep the original track, mute it, delete it, create a new project? And how do you want to name the new tracks? Click OK, and now you have one left and one right track. Feature 2. You know this one when you have the range tool and you hold Shift and Command or Control. You can hover over segments and change the gain. But if you want to change the clip gain of an entire event, you might look for this fader, which is very tiny. So an easier way is to use the same combination, Shift and Command or Control, but when you have the regular selection tool instead of the range tool. And to make it even better, go and click this one, combine selection tools, then the top half gives you the segment detection tool, and the bottom half gives you regular clip gain. Feature 3. When you're editing with Snap activated and you want to make a quick but precise edit, you don't have to press J to turn Snap off, do the edit, and then press J again. You can just leave Snap on and hold Command or Control to override it. Feature 4. If you need a fade on both sides of an event, you don't have to drag these. You also don't have to select and press A. Press A again. You can just select the middle part with the range tool and then press A. Feature 5 is about solos. Let's say you want to work on individual tracks, so you solo this one by clicking or hitting S, you do your editing, then unsolo it and solo the next one, and so on. You can do this faster by using exclusive solo, which is holding Command or Control and clicking any solo button. But what if I wanted to keep hearing this one track, maybe a vocal track, while I'm doing these exclusive solos? That's when Solo Defeat comes in. On the track you want to keep hearing, click and hold the solo button until it changes, or use Option or Alt and click. And now when I solo any of these tracks, the vocal track never gets muted. Feature 7. A very fast way of copying MIDI events is to drag this handle on the side. And if you do that while holding Shift, you're creating shared copies. Which means if you change the MIDI in one of them, it changes for every shared copy. And feature 8. If you're assigning inputs and outputs to multiple tracks, and they all need to be the same, you can select the tracks, hold Shift and Option or Alt, which is Quick Link, and then change it. But if you need to assign sequential inputs or outputs, just hold Shift, then click the first one, and it'll automatically assign the next ones in ascending order.
So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video and also subscribe. And have fun making music!